Hello friends, my name is Panindra. In this tutorial, let us learn about circulatory system of periplaneta americana. And periplaneta americana means nothing but a cockroach. And let us learn about the circulatory system. Firstly, I will share the introduction of this circulatory system of the periplaneta americana. And firstly, let us give the introduction. And the introduction is, it mainly consists of open type of blood circulation. What is mean by open type? It pumps the blood into a hemocell with the blood diffusing back to the circulatory system between the what we say cells. Or else blood is pumped to the heart by the body cavities where tissues are surrounded by the blood. This is nothing but an open type, and blood vessels are poorly developed and open into the spaces. What do you understand by these sentences? Blood vessels are poorly developed. While compared with this to the human, our blood vessels are highly developed, but there are no spaces which are mainly present in our body. That is, our blood vessels will be totally congested and will be free. And will be highly specialized developed. But when compared to this circulatory system of this periplaneta americana, the blood vessels are poorly developed. And visceral organs. All these visceral organs are mainly present in the hemocell. Hemocell is a part of the body where it mainly consists of visceral organs. What are visceral organs? I will say you afterwards. In this video, I will say you afterwards. You will get to know. And the hemocell. And that hemocell is a body part which mainly consists of visceral organs. And this hemocell will be totally patched up by the blood. The blood is nothing but which is hemolymph. And what we have to say is blood circulatory system. The main parts of the blood circulatory system is hemocell, heart, and hemolymph. Firstly, let us talk about hemocell. Hemocell mainly divided into three sinuses: pericardial sinus. Or it is also said as dorsal sinus, perivisceral sinus, or middle sinus, and it also divided into perineural sinus or ventral sinus. And in this, pericardial sinus, it is also said as dorsal sinus. This upper red color which I have drawn is known as pericardial sinus. Perivisceral sinus is a yellow color which I have drawn is known as perivisceral sinus. And again, this black color outer border is said to be as perineural sinus, where it is also known as middle sinus or ventral sinus. And see here, and try to understand clearly here, with the help of two body cavities, there is nothing but diaphragm, with the help of two diaphragms, that is dorsal diaphragm and ventral diaphragm. This is dorsal diaphragm and this is ventral diaphragm. With the help of this both dorsal diaphragm and ventral diaphragm, this circulatory system, that is nothing but hemocell, is mainly divided into pericardial, perivisceral, and perineural sinuses. With the help of this both diaphragms, dorsal diaphragm and ventral diaphragm, with the help of these both diaphragms, this hemocell is mainly divided into three sinuses: pericardial sinus or dorsal sinus, perivisceral sinus or middle sinus, perineural sinus, or it is also said to be as ventral sinus. And this is about hemocell. One more important thing which you have to discuss in hemocell is the middle sinus. That is nothing but, see here, yellow color, perivisceral sinus, which is also said to be as middle sinus. Middle sinus is very much large. This yellow color, which is said to be as perivisceral sinus, it is much large when compared to the pericardial sinus and perineural sinus. What you understand is perivisceral sinus, which is yellow in color, is much large when compared to the pericardial sinus and perineural sinus. And this dorsal and ventral sinuses, that is nothing but pericardial sinus and perivisceral sinus. Pericardial sinus and perineural sinus, that is nothing but dorsal and ventral sinuses, are small in size, I have said you, when compared to the perivisceral sinus, that is nothing but middle sinus, which is yellow in color in the diagram. And why both are short in size? Because it is mainly enclosed with heart and nerve cord. See here, it is mainly enclosed with heart. Okay, it mainly enclosed with the heart, and these both circles are said to be as nerve cord. And this is about hemocell. Well, coming into the heart of the periplaneta americana, it is mainly present in the dorsal sinus, that is nothing but pericardial sinus. See here, what I have said is this is the known as dorsal sinus, which is also known as pericardial sinus. Here, this is the heart. Heart is mainly present in the dorsal sinus, or else it is also said to be as pericardial sinus. And it is long muscular tube-like structure. This is the heart.
All of this red color long tube which I have drawn is said to be as heart. This is known as heart, and heart mainly consists of 13 chambers. See, count properly here: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and 13. Be visible here, 13. Okay, and when you draw this in the examinations, please do draw diagrams perfectly. That heart should be mainly consists of only 13 chambers. Draw the 13 chambers. If you draw 14 chambers or as 12 chambers, then the examiner mainly wrong the paper. So we should draw only 13 chambers. So what we have to say is heart mainly consists of 13 chambers, and in the 13 chambers, the 3 chambers are mainly present in the thorax region, and 10 of the chambers are mainly present in the abdomen region. Okay, 3 of them are mainly present in the thorax region. See, this is the thorax region. This 1, 2, 3.
These 3 chambers are mainly present in the thorax region. Remaining all 10 chambers are mainly present in the abdomen region. Okay. And another organ, ostia. Ostia. Yeah. What is meant by ostia is?
See, ostia is an organ which mainly
receives the blood from the pericardial sinus and mainly pumps that blood into the heart. This is the pericardial sinus or dorsal sinus. The blood which is mainly present in the pericardial sinus or dorsal sinus, it will enter into the heart by the help of the organ known as ostia. Okay, this is the main function of the ostia.
Next, blood. To talk of the blood and
hemolymph. Hemolymph is nothing but said to be as blood. And in our body, in human body, the blood is red in color due to presence of hemoglobin. Due to the presence of pigment known as hemoglobin. But whereas when compared our human to this periplaneta americana, the blood which is mainly present in this body is colorless. So the hemolymph which is mainly present in the periplaneta americana is colorless due to the presence of the pigment known as
hemoglobin. And this blood hemolymph mainly consists of plasma corpuscles and hemocytes. What are these three? These three are known as phagocytes.
Acts as phagocytes. What is mean by phagocytes are?
Phagocytes is a substance which mainly helps in attraction or else attraction of the other bacteria or else harmful substances. It mainly absorbs the harmful substances and mainly takes that harmful substances and make them enter into the host. What is host here? The body of this periplaneta americana is said to be as host.
So this mainly acts as phagocytes. What is phagocyte is? They are large in size, and what they do is it mainly helps to attract the foreign particles. What are the foreign particles? It may be viruses, bacteria, harmful substances. It may be good or else bad. It mainly takes that foreign substances and mainly helps to inject that foreign substances into the host. The what is the host here? The body part of the this periplaneta americana. This is about the blood, and let us talk about the functions of this blood of the periplaneta americana. And I have said you before that when compared to this our body, our large intestine mainly consists of a microvilli which are finger-like substances. What is the main function of this microvilli? It mainly absorbs the nutrients which are mainly present in our body
by the food material of which we consume.
So in the same way, the blood which is mainly present in the periplaneta americana, what it does is it mainly absorbs the food material from the alimentary canal, and it sends that nutrients which is mainly absorbed from the alimentary canal to other body parts. This is the main function, one of the main function of the blood. And another function is it brings nitrogenous waste from all the body parts of the body. For example, if you take in the human kidney mainly acts as for the purification of the blood, whereas lungs also mainly acts as for the purification of the blood. In the same way, here also the nitrogenous waste from all the body parts of the body. Where the excretory organs also helps in the major role for this function. And one more thing which we have to say is there are ductless glands which are mainly present in this body of this periplaneta americana. What is the main function of the ductless glands? It mainly releases some secretions, and the secretions it releases into the blood and into the blood of this periplaneta americana, and that blood will be transported from one part to other part of the target organ. Okay, this is the main these are the three main functions of this blood of the periplaneta americana. So now let us talk about the circulatory system of the periplaneta americana. Now let us discuss about the blood circulation of the periplaneta americana, and firstly let us learn about the parts.
this is the anterior aorta. The first chamber is said to be as anterior aorta, and this is the valvular opening. And I have said to you that there are 13 chambers which are mainly present in the heart of the periplaneta americana, and each of the chamber will be open to another chamber, and that chamber will open to another chamber. And
due to that opening, what is that opening is said to be as valvular opening. With the presence of valvular opening, the blood which is mainly present from one chamber will move to the another chamber with the help of valvular opening. And these are alary muscles, the triangle shaped, which are mainly known as alary muscles, and these are paired each other. And these are paired structures which are mainly present each other throughout its opposite side. And this is the all of these are 13 heart chambers. And these are about the body parts of the circulatory system. Now let us learn about the circulatory system of the blood of periplaneta americana and aorta. I have said you the anterior aorta in the diagram. And from the anterior aorta, the blood mainly enters into perivisceral sinus or perineural sinus. And this is known as perivisceral sinus,
yellow color, which I said is known as perivisceral sinus and perineural sinus. And from the
aorta, it mainly enters into the perivisceral sinus and perineural sinus. And from the it enters into the pericardial septum. What is meant by pericardial septum is pericardial sinus is mainly present in the septum, is said to be as pericardial septum.
And the blood firstly meter enters into pericardial septum, then the contraction of pericardial septum takes place. When the contraction of pericardial septum takes place, then what happens is pericardial sinus, the volume of the pericardial sinus will be large. So what happens, the amount of blood will enter into the pericardial sinus. Listen carefully,
pericardial septum will contract. And due to the contraction of the pericardial septum, the blood will enter into the pericardial sinus because the volume of the pericardial sinus will be large due to the contraction of the pericardial septum,
where pericardial sinus is also known as dorsal sinus.
And from the pericardial septum, it enters into the pericardial sinus, I have said, you know. And from the pericardial sinus, it enters into the heart. So this is the heart.
This is the pericardial sinus, which is also known as dorsal sinus. The blood which is mainly present in the pericardial sinus or dorsal sinus will enter into the heart. Okay, and here what happens is the heart starts relaxation. Here the pericardial septum will start contraction, and that blood will enter up to the heart. And what happens in the heart is the heart gets relaxed. So what happens, the blood which is mainly present in the heart will move to the aorta. Okay, again aorta will move to the aorta. Then what happens, again the cycle starts. The aorta sends the blood to the perivisceral sinus, perineural sinus, and again to the another, finally to the heart. In this way, the circulation takes place in the periplaneta americana, and this system is said to be as tracheal system. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, please do like and subscribe. Thank you.